Numen Collective actually consists out of four people, which is like Andreas Greiner, Felix Kiesling, Julien Chaillard, and me, Markus Hoffmann. We together met like about 7 years ago at the same time studying at the same place, and then we sparked each other's interest and started to form a group that works together each year for 2 or 3 shows. The piece, Das Numen Meatus, that we are showing here is actually a representation of the winds that are on the surface of our planet. And it is actually transforming those winds at specific locations into a composition of sound that invites the viewer to listen to and travel throughout the planet or over the planet, being constantly located all 30 seconds on another place and enjoy this composition. The piece that I'm showing here is like called Atlas, and the work Atlas basically consists out of a column that is about 4 meters high, which is made out of the radioactive ore from the Rosner mine, which is about 200 kilometers away from Prague, and white concrete and some pieces that are lying on the floor. So you are actually facing something more or less like a future fossil artifact that has been artificially made, and it also like shows you something that is not visible, or it just gives you a space to relate to. Opposite this piece, there is another work that relates to it called Green Sediment, and Green Sediment is actually an autoradiography also made with radioactive material, but from all active nuclear uranium mines on the planet that has been exposed for exactly 1 year. So actually you find different timescales in this moment, and yeah, I mean, the meaning is something that probably the viewer is invited to relate himself to it. Because I think that the radioactive remains that we leave on our planet are the fossils of the future, and they are kind of infusing all different sectors, like politically, like ecologically, and they just like have time scales that are far beyond our own perception, and as well are out of our own perception, which actually means we cannot feel, we cannot smell, we cannot hear, and we cannot sense in another way radioactivity, but it's still there, and it's going to change the way we are living together on the planet. And I think that's very interesting because it reactualizes over time, and that's why it captured me for such a long moment.